Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Siege. As per usual, we're jumping on in here, and when we last left off, we killed a little dragon. Well, I think it was a drake. But it's a little dragon in my mind. Does this signify that we're almost done with this hellish place? I don't know. I'm hopeful. But it looks like we got some work to do yet. And that lack of healing potions, I'm feeling it, guys. It's something we are going to be stocking up on in our next shop. Come on, guys, get in there. Everybody drink, everybody drink. Everybody that can drink, I guess, drink. Ah, free heals. I'm not excited about him gaining melee skill. Oh no, I'm excited about that free heal that comes along with gaining melee skill. Okay, I do not want Arnold. I want Devon. Oh, this is promising. There's a person in there. We shall set you free! Erasmus!
I've been suspended for what? Nearly a month now. Most astonishing. The powers have grown. I should have been paying closer attention. I should have foreseen this. Blast it! The forces behind this violence will be searching for my warding staff. That's the magical artifact they're after. Thanks to me, they believe it to have powers it doesn't actually possess. But it could still be a terrible weapon in the wrong hands. It must be recovered.
Okay, who are you? Merik? Okay, so apparently we now have to find this staff. A new quest has been added to our journal. Retrieve Merrick's warning staff. How novel! We're at chapter 4. I don't remember how many there are.
With the Grand Mage freed from his icy tomb, it was now clear that there was an evil hand behind the forces overwhelming the kingdom. Our hero went forth seeking clues to the whereabouts of the warding staff.
I really have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just kind of killing everything that gets in my way. Gee, oh my god. Oh yes, I like it. They charge ahead just enough to aggro 90% of these things. Yeah, let's back off a little bit, guys. Let's try and do this a little bit more intelligently. As much as I know you enjoy aggroing every enemy in the group, let's maybe go with, you know, half of the enemies for once. See how that works. Cracked rigid leather. That might be an upgrade for someone. I'm kind of doubtful. Oh, Zed is down. As Mr. Satanislav said, Zed's dead! Zed is dead, baby! And I'm honestly surprised I didn't make that joke myself. I'm disappointed in myself. Here, let's get Zed standing again so that he can start healing people. There we go. Alright, I don't think that cracked rigid leather is gonna be worth anything. Okay, and I need him? Yeah. He needs healing potions. Zed have some mana. Okay, so we've got three of these guys left. And a dragon. Wyrm, wyvern, whatever. No. Alright. Oh no you don't! You cheeky bastards. Come on. I know what you're playing at. I'm not okay with it. Kill that one that is trying to maim someone in the back row. There will be no caster maiming on my watch. Alright, and somebody just increased in intelligence, which pleases me. I don't even know who it was, but it's a good thing. Frost Drake, round 2, fight. I see you over there, big door thing. Or possibly outside, I can't tell from here. Oh, come on, Devon just increased in strength. I don't think that's any new gear, but I will check. No, those are crap. Who picked up the hat? You picked up the hat. That is also crap. Alright, so whose intelligence just went up? Is it one of you guys? 15, 15. Not anything that... Yeah, it looks like it was Eulora's intelligence. which is sadly not high enough to get her any useful equipment upgrades. Much disappointment. Okay. Oh, so it was a door. I was gonna say, what's your bag, door? What's the trick? Instead, we're gonna save, because I fear everything. Okay, let's try this again. Come on, just give me like a little trading post. I just need a building with a guy in it that's like, hey man, I got some potions. You want some potions? And he can be like as shifty as he wants to be. I don't even care. I just need potions. Sweet Jesus, let me buy potions. Please. Krug has advanced to level 12 in melee. Nice. It is, like, you can watch them. You can watch their skills progress over here. They level so quickly by comparison to my casters. My casters go up and it's a major event. My melees go up and I'm just kind of mostly pleased that they got free healing. Oh, this is gonna end up bad. We got Brack Mages. And a little fairy. And if I recall correctly, the last time we followed one of those things, it helped us, so we're probably gonna follow that one too. If I kill this thing, ah! Cloth, which is probably junk. Alright, fairy, where are you? Lead me into danger and rewards. Yes. Where are we going, little fairy? Whatever. Krug, follow the fairy. Follow the purple fairy, Krug. Oh! That's promising. I've got you now. What are you gonna do, huh? Alright, so it just seems to be pathing around in a direction that takes it away from us. Oh shit, I think I remember this guy. There's like a crazy guy in here. Who will also join you.
Who are you then? Another of that short goblin cusses errand runners? You tell that little green snotball I don't have any high and mighty magic staff, and I never did. I don't traffic in exotics, and even if I did have one, I'm not gonna go trudging through the eastern swamp looking to sell it to some damn foreigner. Now, if there's anything else I can get you today, maybe I'll consider not tossing your ugly butt out into the... Save me the pretty goodbyes and get moving!
Yeah, I remember this dude. We're gonna sell him things.
You're about as...
Yeah. Okay, so how are we looking? How are my mages looking on potions? My mages have got healing or mana potions. So, oh my god, you can control click! Oh! That's a... Oh, so good. This is great. This is great. I don't know how I didn't think to hold down control when I was trying to figure out how to do it in the past. I'm not, oh wow, we timed this perfectly. We're just gonna do kind of like a passer here, and I'm gonna click madly. I'm sure you guys, you headphone wearers out there are, I'm sure, being moderately deafened by this. We are probably going to have a boatload of money because there is a pretty decent number of spell scrolls in here. Okay, how are we looking? 46,000 gold, and with armor that costs 16,000, we are going to need every piece. First, though, potions. Now, if I remember correctly, you can just, yeah, restock. Alright, I'm gonna get 3 rows for each of my frontliners. So, this should ideally keep us well stocked into the near future. How far future, I don't know. I'm not worried about my casters because they shouldn't, in theory, be eating too much damage. In theory. Okay. So, miscellaneous. He's got some books. I wonder if that's anything interesting. What is this? Spellbook. Oh, like magic spell books that no one has the intelligence to use, and that one's 83,000 gold pieces. Spellbook of a Revendication. That's a new word right there. Some shields, some weapons, armor. I'm curious. Like, whatever this is, only strength 14. Like, this is... I'm honestly tempted to buy a suit of this for... basically every front row I... every front row doesn't really need it. I want to buy this for him. Can we do anything with Devon? No. Nature magic, huh? But it requires a strength of 21. Like, no caster's gonna be able to use that. No, I don't think that's really too valuable. Okay, weapons. What do we got? 41 to 54. That's an upgrade. Mana stealing. None of the weapons really seem good enough to be worth picking up, I don't think. I don't sell any of them exotics except for all of these spells I got. Summon Scorpion. Yeah, look at this. It's like level 20. Explode body. Fireball. Triple strike. Shit, I won't be able to cast for the entirety of this Let's Play. Okay, so what are you guys? Well, you guys are just helpless. You get nothing. On the back of the party, just... Wow, it's basically me and Gjorn. Well, Devon and Gjorn, they can grab upgrades here, which I'm thinking I'm gonna grab something for Gjorn. This is better. Bam. All right, no, equip it. White. Okay. Weird. Maybe I'm just being weird and I don't know, whatever. Okay, 30 to 37, that is an upgrade for you. Dwarf bro. You are almost to strength 16. So, well, you're a two-handed fighter anyways. I think this is not going to work for you. And he doesn't have anything else that you're actually ever going to be strong enough to use. So, yeah, good for you. Didn't I buy this for him? I actually think, since he's a two-hander, I'm going to buy him the flexible scale. Just to kind of shore his defense up a little bit. He's actually second best defense in the party now. Wow, that's, well, no, that's because I've got him with a bunch of magic rings and stuff that are shoring that up. Okay, I think that's about all I'm gonna get here. I thought that guy would join your party, but apparently I was mistaken. Kind of sad. But if anything, we are now stocked for healing, which, hell yeah. I'm tempted to just load the mule up on healing items too, but meh. All right, so let's find out where we're supposed to go. Oh, apparently this way. Okay. Come, my erstwhile party members. And murder that thing with a claw. Spelled with a K because, I don't know, I can't even be like, it's the 90s, everything had to be hardcore, because it was the 2000s, this was the early 2000s. We were past the, like, I can't even say that with a straight face, that we were, Pixie is giving you a gift of mana. Thanks, Pixie. You give me a gift of mana, but your bro was like, screw you, I hate you, die in a fire. Some of these Pixies guys, real jerks. Go ahead, there we go. Pick up all the gold. But no, like, that was honestly, I think, a pretty good shopping trip there. I made a lot of money. I was not expecting to come out of that with, you know, 40,000, 48,000, however much gold it was. I mean, as I said, admittedly, we needed it, and in a couple cases, we could have used more if I wanted to buy magic spell books. But I'm pretty pleased with what we got there. Our dwarf kind of got some better defense, which he sorely needed because he does not have a shield, and yeah, I'm pretty pleased with it. And, you know, healing potions, which we kind of needed a little bit. Take the gold. There you go. Keep hearing wolves snarling, but I don't know where they are. Oh, no, there it is. Okay. I keep hearing wolves, guys. I wonder if there's wolves around. It's dead. What's going on down here? Arnold's getting the shit stomped out of him. So is Glorn. Come on, guys. If you focus them down, they can't kill you as efficiently. See? See how that works? I know it's complicated. That's crap. I know it's complicated, but... Come on now. One at a time. This is not a race. I have to pause it so that I can target them properly without accidentally targeting something else. Or, you know, clicking one of my party members, because I totally want to do that. Okay, we're getting some magic bows and stuff, but I'm really not too interested in them. Oh, and it looks like, hey, guess what? More caves. This is new and interesting. What the hell? Dark Lungers. I think these things deal a lot of damage too, maybe. No, apparently not. I don't know, for some reason when I saw those things, I had an immediate urge to get away from it. But yeah, they don't really seem to be particularly dangerous. Linen. They make weird sound effects. That is one thing that I will give this game, is that the monsters are not, you know, your bog standard. I mean, you got, I guess, Krugs, which are goblin analogs, orc analogs, or whatever. But everything else is, you know, fairly unique. Oh, Arnold's getting the crap shocked out of him by a teal shard. Gotta watch out, guys. Oh, man, a potion. Go get the potion. Yes. And he doesn't take it. Freaking jackasses, take the damn potion. Thank you. Let's do some violence. A garment. Okay. What else we got? Well, so far this has not been too bad. Those things are probably dangerous in swarms, but just one or two of them isn't too bad. Slargs. I don't even know what that's supposed to look like, but it's disgusting. Lectars. Lectars have a lot of hit points. Holy crap. Slargs, less so. I think there's actually one coming up behind my party. Yeah. No, that's the mule. Gotta keep an eye out for slargs and wayward mules in these caves. Hey there, frame rate. I don't know what that was. Oh, mana potion. Or mana thing. That's nice. And we got some shards, which... Shards seem to be doing some damage. Okay, so the shards are dangerous. Guys, for Christ's sake. Nope. 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 None of that. Things trying to lure us into horribleness back there. I don't even know. Alright. I love how the monsters basically ignore my entire back row in favor of the melees. It's as it should be. Aw, yeah, Naidi just increased in strength. Croduck just increased in strength. Ah, violence. Naidi, is that a new bow? That is a new bow. 25 to 39. That is also a point into ranged. She's losing some mana steal, but seeing as she doesn't ever cast spells, I think that might be okay. Her damage went up a little bit. Not hugely, but hey, incremental upgrades are still upgrades. Naidi is advanced to level 8 and ranged. Man, it's a good day for her. And that is two spells, Ice Shard and Flame. Come on, guys, get up there and screw these things up before they murder you. Ignore the slarg or the lectar, it is no threat. It just looks like some weird lizard thing that kind of is perturbed. As my chair kind of creaks in the background. Oh, creaky chair, you're getting there. Give it time, you'll be squeaking like the old one. Oh, that, those are enemies, I'm sure, right there. Bjorn just leveled his melee, nice. And a bow, which I don't really care about, but I will take. I was hoping to avoid an encounter with you. Apparently it was not to be. As Zed is, you know, necessary in the front row here. I mean, he's just gotta be there. It's where he belongs. Oh. So they're dead. Admittedly, we're chewing through these things pretty easily. I'm not really worried yet. They certainly do need to be focused down over stuff like this, because these guys are actually dangerous. I don't know why I was so worried about these. I think the reason I'm afraid of the Dark Lungers is because there's an enemy in... I don't know if they're in this game or if they're only in the multiplayer world, but there are monsters that look exactly like these things you fight in a swamp that are incredibly nasty. Drink your healing potion. There you go. Come on, guys. Okay. Yeah, they're like a reskin of these things, and I recall that... Well, no, those might not have been these. They might have been... Because I think they were like swamp trolls, and they were these and a swamp troll, and this is a tiny little monster. Like these things that just wrecks your face. Okay, we have a chest. Trapped. Beautiful. Okay, that one right there. No. Pleasant surprise. Oh, this is... Oh, I didn't even see these things over here. I was just saying, we went a little while here without anything trying to kill us. This worries me a little bit. Oh, guys, yeah. Savage these things. You got nothing. Hey, level 8 in melee for... level 18 in melee for Devon. That is appealing. I seem to recall there being a giant one of these things in here, and that's a boss that we have to fight. Again, though, my memory is garbled. Where's the mule? The mule's... Heck, they're doing something. I just saw it go running off. You know what? Mule attempting to drown itself. You saw it here first. Okay. Whoa. So where am I going? Over here? Yes. No. No. Where am I going? Was this just an offshoot, maybe? Yes. This was just a little side area. Okay. I didn't even see that stairway going down there. All right. That's fine. Okay, looks like some more of these slargs. It's a fitting name. They look like a slarg. I don't know what a slarg is, but I would imagine that it has a facial sphincter much like that. Let's murder these things. And I think that Elora is doing really well with that fire shards or fire cone spell, whatever it is, fire spray. Man, Krug leveled in melee, Yor increased in strength. Lorne is going to increase in his axe or his melee skill pretty shortly here. Yelora is actually looking like she's going to be bumping up in combat magic, too. The only one being left behind is Zed. Because, damn it, Zed. You can't do anything right! Okay. Violence the hell out of these things. See that short bow, and I want it. I do kind of appreciate the auto loot button. I kind of really appreciate the auto loot button. Whoa. Okay, Osiris. I don't know if this is a boss or just... Alright, so breath weapon. Alright, that wasn't honestly that bad, I guess. Certainly could have been worse. Oh, is this another just like side area? This is another side area, wow, okay. Wow. Alright, in that case, let's see, well, I suppose we have some, yeah, we have over here. Okay, I was gonna say, I don't know where to go, but it's not nearly that complicated. This is very much not a game where you get lost. This is kind of like Titan Quest in that it's a large static world. And a lot of people In regards to Titan Quest, I remember it more so with Titan Quest than this. Because when this came out, the internet was still kind of in its infancy. At least it was for me. I actually didn't get broadband internet. I was with a 56K modem until, I want to say 2004 or 2005. Just because we lived out in the boonies and there just wasn't any service. But when this came out, I don't remember hearing too much about it because obviously I wasn't on the internet all the time then like I am now. But with Titan Quest, I remember one of the biggest complaints about the game being that it was a linear world. And, you know, people are saying, you know, well, if the world's linear, there's going to be no replayability. And I don't know that I necessarily agree with that. But obviously the developers of Titan Quest did, because in Grim Dawn, their next game, the world is static, but the path through the world is randomized every time you load the game, if that makes sense. Like, basically, imagine if, say you're in a dungeon, right? And there are three paths to go through this dungeon, and Naiti's going to get herself killed. And I don't even care, because she did something stupid. Anyway, say there are three paths through this dungeon. How they randomized it? In every playthrough, two of those three paths will be closed off. And from what I've seen of the game, well, I shouldn't say what I've seen. I've put probably, I don't know, 20 hours into the early release. God, what do they call it? Early access, I think, is the term they use for them now. The Dark Forest. All right. I put 20 or 30 hours into the early access, and really, like, I understand what they're doing, but I don't feel that it adds anything to the game at all. It doesn't randomize things in a meaningful fashion. It basically, again, from what I've seen, it takes a path that would... Are they chasing after my mule? Where's my mule? No, okay. It takes a path that would take, you know, it basically... It modifies paths that would only take like 10 seconds to traverse. So the randomization to the world isn't, like I said, it's not meaningful. It's just randomization of the path for the sake of randomization. It doesn't really add anything, I don't think. Hey now, don't be killing yourself. All right, this is gonna be trouble. Trogs are also pretty nasty, I've noticed. They hit us kinda hard, but. So yeah, Grim Dawn is actually a really good game. It's an action RPG, like I said, by the same guys that did Titan Quest Iron Lore, although they're under Crate Entertainment now because I think it was THQ owned Iron Lore and THQ went out of business, and so I don't know who owns the copyright to the Iron Lore name now. But yeah, I highly, highly recommend checking it out if you like Titan Quest. It's you can tell it's the exact same engine because it is. But the game is much faster than Titan Quest. It's also violent as hell. I actually really enjoy it. Come up here and loot stuff. Who's getting killed? Naiti. I know that's Eulora getting beaten up over here. Devon has increased in dexterity. But yeah, no, I highly recommend it. I think it's a better game than Titan Quest already. They've basically got a sort of trait system like what you had in Path of Exile. It's based on finding these relics, like these hidden shrines and stuff around the world that give you points to spend towards working through this fairly large passive skill tree, although I believe there are some active skills in there too. But the game itself is, I think, very, very solid. The only thing that some people might view as a downside is it's got kind of like steampunk atmosphere to it, so you've got guns and grenades and stuff in there. And the gunslinger class, I can't remember what its name is off the top of my head, is actually really fun to play. That's actually the class that I play when I run around. But no, I highly recommend checking it out. I think they just recently, I think, hit feature complete, so they're working on basically polishing the game, and then they're getting ready to release it. So it's basically all there at this point in time. But we are at half an hour, so I'm gonna finish this fight up here, and we're gonna call it. Revive and healing wind. So, as per usual, folks, you sucker. You're interrupting my monologue, my outro, no! You must die. And this is where my entire party gets wiped by crystals. Seriously though, game, I was joking. You can stop now. Come on. Ooh, and there's a wooden buckler. Okay, there we go. Alright, so drink. Drink. And I'm gonna call it. So, as usual, folks, thank you for watching. Check out Grim Dawn. It's a good game. Until next time.